Since you'll be putting in effort in keeping fees low, are you worried that people will flock to the platform just for cashing out? So, for example, people who have never deposited or used the platform will just put a whole bunch of Bitcoin, convert to euro, and then pull the euro off of the exchange into their bank account. Do you think this will hurt your liquidity, and do you have a plan to counter this sort of action?
Sure, that's actually a great question. There will be like circuit breakers involved in this as well. So, for example, you will have an aggregate volume of how much you've traded. So, if you deposit, let's say, 10 Bitcoin and immediately try to withdraw it, you would not be able to. You would have to trade a certain amount based on the deposit amount. So, if you influx 10 Bitcoin onto the exchange, you will be required to trade X percent of that Bitcoin or X times that Bitcoin in margin trading before you're actually available to pull it to fiat. You can exchange it to other tokens based on, we will basically have a running, this is something we learned from FX Pig. So margin management is key in FX as well. So let's say, for example, in the FX industry, we have 15, 16, 17 different liquidity providers where we need to hold margin or credit. We have an aggregation system where orders are sent to those different liquidity providers. We need to make sure, however, that we don't get overloaded with orders at one specific liquidity provider, or we get margin calls, and then we lose money. So we have a system in place there that basically checks every 2 seconds every single trade that's open at every single liquidity provider, checks the margin, makes sure that we're stable, and if one starts to go outside of certain parameters, it then transfers trades to different liquidity providers. And that same type of system will work here. So we will constantly monitor what we have available in certain tokens. So in situations like this, if someone tries to move to a different token and then withdraw, there will be a warning message previously that says that they haven't yet meet their minimum trade amount, and that if they do exchange to that specific token, they would only be able to withdraw X amount of that token. So yes, we will have something in place to, and that those rule sets, because basically this all boils down, and I talk about this a lot with other things, to protocols. A lot of businesses run into problems because they don't follow basic protocols. Most of the hacks, quote unquote, you've seen are due to protocols. So somebody has a private key on a machine, they're at a hotel lobby, they log on to check their email, somebody gets into their computer, finds a private key, and that's it. Somebody leaves a private key written out on their desk and leaves it at work. Somebody has a private key listed in their cell phone, and they pull it up when they're on a bus or a train. These are the type of things that happen, or they email a sensitive data back and forth, or they put it on Dropbox or Google Drive, and somebody gets into one computer that's listed to that Google Drive and gets in the information. All those type of things are also protocols. So it's important for a company to have protocols. So here, these protocols are rule sets, and over time, those rule sets will adopt. Right? It's difficult to have every possible scenario inside a rule set initially, but from the FX side, we have some experience in these type of things, so we will apply different rule sets, and then over time, we may get caught once or twice and say, ah, this guy, this guy figured out a way to skirt one of those rules. You give that guy a pat on the back, and let's change the rule set. So these things do evolve over time, but we have experience, like I said, in creating these type of rules. So yes, there will be filters in place for people that try to take advantage of our low fees. And there will be other rule sets in place to make sure that a normal client who comes on, deposits 10,000 euro, tries to trade a little bit of Bitcoin and says, this isn't for me, and then wants to withdraw their euro. That's fine. No problem there. They can do that immediately. There's no filter there, they're fine. And so those rule sets, again, will morph over time, but yes, we will be prepared for these type of certain situations.